This episode sponsored also by MyBookie.ag. Winning season returns at MyBookie. Winning season means doubling your first deposit. Winning season means Survivor, Super Contests, and Squares. At MyBookie, winning season means hitting all your parlays and props with your feet up, watching your team trounce their rivals. Rejoice. It's time to celebrate the NFL season. Invest in your intuition. Use promo code TimboSugarShow and double your first deposit. New players get up to $1,000 in free play, designed to add more excitement to the sports you love and the games you bet. From live betting to championship futures, every play you want to make is waiting at MyBookie. It's simple. Make your picks, win big, collect your cash. Use promo code TimboSugarShow and double your first deposit. Your winning season begins today only at MyBookie.
Drop. Check. 1, 2. Are we rolling? Okay.
Are you going to just let Theo play in the background? Or?
Episode 104.
Should we just have Theo play in the background and pretend like he's here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Episode 104. Sponsored by Jocko Fuel. Some of my favorite drinks. He's also got these Jocko Go supplements. It has a bunch of vitamins and then caffeine. I took those yesterday. Didn't have to chug a bunch of shit. Felt good. Fucking lifted hard. But these Jocko Go drinks, they're really good. They have a bunch of BCAAs in them. They're sweetened with monk fruit extract, and they have 95 milligrams of caffeine. In a lot of those other energy drinks, there's preservatives. There's a bunch of shit that just fucks with you. But these are nice. These are real nice. Jocko Fuel, they got boots. They got tons of good supplements. Like I said, those are the supplements I've been taking. The fish oils, the vitamin D3s, the energy drinks. American made in Maine. Promo code SugarShow for 15% off. Jocko Fuel. Yeah, and that's our sponsors for the day. Dude. Fucking no weed. I sleep so good. I owe Sugar $500 if I smoke weed Monday through Thursday in October. I'm going to give it a shot because when I was quarantined for that COVID, I had to completely shut off the marijuana and completely shut off the caffeine. And I was sleeping so fucking good. And then as soon as I'm ready to smoke, I smoke a bit again, and I wake up, and I'm just not quite
as
clear.
I'm telling you, it's because you got to do it too close to bed.
Yes.
Because my sleep fucking fire as fuck, dude, and I'm smoking
marijuana. I think the ratios
are
right. I think just like you said.
It's just before bed.
Before bed. If you smoke too heavy before bed and then the weed wears off, I think it somehow wakes you up. And I've felt that. If I smoke right before bed, I fucking fall asleep. But then 3 a.m. I wake up.
Well, I think you get up to go pee. Well, for me, I get up to go pee and then I'm like up. But if I don't sleep too close to bed and I get up to go pee, I can go right back to sleep.
Just boom it.
But I don't know, dude. It's bro science.
But yeah, it is fucking bro science. But also, what we say.
Well,
when I train and then I smoke at night, I'm like, wow, my body is hungry.
Yeah,
get extra hungry. I eat a little bit too much.
It's also not just bro science. Dude, I've been tracking my sleep with my Oura Ring for over 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
You're getting a good idea, huh?
Yeah. I'm fucking sore, dude. Because this week I literally trained. I've had the same schedule as if I was in camp. Because I did my sprints yesterday, wrestled yesterday, and then did my 2 Monday practices. I woke up at 7 this morning, went and trained with Brandon, was mostly...
Damn,
we still trained, but I was more recovery because I was so fucking sore. My goddamn legs.
They're starting to turn into trunks.
Fucking feeling, yeah, they're huge.
I lifted yesterday for the first time in fucking
at Boss?
3 weeks, dude. Some kettlebells, some explosive jumps, explosive lunges, some deadlifts.
Your heart
and dude,
up.
Right after you fucking... Yeah, first of all, it horns you up because Vasa is just crawling with those girls wearing those sexy little fucking spandex.
Don't look at me. It's like, bitch, what are you, what? Why are you wearing bright pink then? Butt cheek shorts?
No, I've been doing better at not staring, so.
And jacking off.
Like, jacking up.
J-Rob's new Sugar Show song dropped Friday. We're doing a music video.
Jax, you going? Yeah. It's going to be lit.
Give me some hot chicks. He sent me all their Instas. I just peeked on them.
I had a dream that I went to, and I acted like super, super like goofy, and J-Rob didn't like it.
No, J-Rob wouldn't care. I feel like we know each other, but we only met each other that one time. Mm-hmm. Or hung out or whatever. But dude, if we just popped a couple ollies, not mollies, like the skateboard and went, that would be crazy.
Got a couple, the girls get a couple ollies in.
Dude, a couple ollies.
Yeah.
A couple odkas.
Dude, I've been seeing some of your Insta stories too. Danny's been cooking up some fucking meals, huh?
Dude, Taco Tuesday. Well, dude, I'm pretty much eating perfect again. From as far as the Garner stuff. Because did we talk about that already? Redid all my blood, shit, stool, piss, saliva, redid all my tests, and he sent me a diet that he wants me on right now. Dude, and I'm eating a lot. Like, this morning I had like 3 eggs, 2 egg whites, and an apple. Just eating fucking perfect. Bone broth.
We posted it on Patreon, too, if you want to see his diet plan. And how to eat for fucking optimal performance for sugar, which is surprising because before, eggs caused you inflammation.
2 years ago, yeah.
2 years ago. And now it's like the beef causes you inflammation. God, it's just so crazy how much your body changes. Because imagine someone who for 10 years ate the same thing every fucking day and it starts to cause them inflammation. Well, they don't even know.
Not even 10 years. Yeah, you'd think you're eating perfect, but that's why change up the diet like Paul Cech has.
Rotation diet.
But dude, when I'm eating good like that, fuck, I have to eat good like that because I want my shit to fucking, my foot's not, it's pretty, it gets sore like pretty easy. I can train 100%, but it's just fucking like I go on a run or anything, I have to ice my foot. I have to put my fucking foot in a bucket of ice for a while every time I train real hard. But if I just keep eating perfect, I shouldn't have to do
that. You guys did Taco Tuesday last night?
Yeah. Fuck,
I know, those tacos are dangerous, especially when you have an option. Okay, you do a little smoke, and then Ryan asks, how many tacos do you want? I want 2. If I smoke, it's 5.
Well, I had 3 the first go, and then I had 1. And then I, those fucking muffins. Or no, cupcakes that Monique had. We had a little get-together. We had some cupcakes that this lady makes, and they're just dangerous. It's like, don't...
Tie-dyed some shit. Dude, and my tie-dye job was sick. Everyone was laughing at my shit.
Danny sent yours?
Uh-huh. Making dude, fun of
they
it,
were,
G.
They literally turned out tight. All turned out sweet. All of them. There wasn't one bad one. They all turned out cool as fuck.
I'm just tie-dye all my shit.
You should.
Yeah, tie-dye, but we got our buddy Kyler Phillips coming in today. He came on a Patreon pod with me a couple weeks ago. Just got done fighting in Abu Dhabi, so I'm pumped to talk about the trip and how it was, the flight and all that stuff. But the fights, Dana, could you pull up the fights?
Marcus went with Kyler, and I talked to him at the lab yesterday. He's like, dude, you can't watch porn there. They have a porn.
No way. Yeah. What?
Yeah.
I ain't going there.
I ain't either. I'm like, what the fuck?
That's illegal to watch porn there, huh?
Well, you just can't. I don't think that you can even get it on your internet or anything.
That is fucking insanity, dude.
What a main event.
Holly Holm. Everyone was talking about how good she looked, which she did. Bouncing around. And that girl, you said.
I was like, she's going to set some sick boxing, but I also thought, like, Holly's good. Go. Which fucking left hand. It's her shit.
Yeah. And then who's the co-main? I forgot.
Izzy messaged me the other day.
What'd he say?
He asked how I got all my how I got my followers all the way down. I said I went down and clicked unfollow on everyone. He said, fuck.
That's cool. Oh, yeah, that Jorgen De Castro.
I didn't see that.
That was a fucking sick. Yeah.
I didn't watch it at all. Remember I left right before Drain and Julia Pena the second round.
Dude, that was a sweet-ass fight. Was that it? Carlos Felipe was like a chubby, did not look like a fucking – athlete, but walking forward, talking shit the whole time, fucking slapping Jorgen.
Nuh-uh.
He said he was a big fan of the Diaz brothers, and you could tell.
That's sick.
He was fighting like them.
That's pretty cool.
And then Jermaine versus Juliana Pena, she caught her in that high elbow guillotine.
Juliana Pena.
Damn. Kyler Phillips versus Cameron. He fucking fucked that kid up.
He did.
I bet that kid's used to training with people.
Not even like, close to Kyler's level.
Yeah, not even close. That's the thing. And Kyler fucking tooled him, dude. Especially, well, the kid was supposed to fight on the Contender Series in November, I think, and then got the call to fight Kyler. And you see Kyler and you think, okay, this kid's fucking, he cannot be that strong. He's soft looking, but he's fucking savage. Carlos Condit, Court McGee.
That was a good little scrap.
Carlos Condit was 2-7 in his last 9 fights, and I think he was on a 5-fight losing streak.
It's kind of lit.
But then it was good to see him fucking win.
Yeah.
Perfect fight. Court McGee, who just like tough, can't crack super hard, has that slow pace.
You see who Gritz is fighting?
Who?
Fuck. Just was in my head, and then it left. Oh, Alex. The kid that Donald fought, Alex fucking...
Oh, Hernandez.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's going to be a dangerous sick fight.
Or it's going to be, yeah, I don't know. That's going to be a sweet fight. That's going to be pretty
that,
cool.
Yeah. Because Gritz's style, Alex Hernandez comes out, tries to finish him, and Gritz is going to be there.
Who knows?
Yeah, exactly.
Casey Kenny, our other buddy, fucked up. Helio Anlong Tung Ang. 14-8.
And now Casey's staying in Abu Dhabi and fighting in 2 more weeks.
Oh, yeah. Who's he fighting?
He's fighting,
That prospect
that
kid.
Wood.
What's his name? Nathaniel.
Nathaniel Wood. Yeah, yeah, so that'll be cool. Sweet.
That'll be cool, cool. My dad called me. Dude, those, like, I never get on Facebook. And, you know those, he's like, I seen your, they're all saying you're fighting TJ Dillashaw's. And I'm sure he saw it on Facebook, some fucking article. I'm like, those articles are just so stupid. I don't know. I researched it. It looked pretty legit.
Saying who's fighting him?
Me. I was like, all right.
Gosh damn. So you guys got some good wrestling in yesterday?
Yeah. Yeah, good wrestling. Partnered up with Mario. It was good to see. I haven't trained with Mario in a while.
You guys just drilled 2-2s and shit?
Yeah, I did 2-2s. And then we did front headlock stuff. What up, Kyler Blood? Come sit down, boy.
We're running, G. We're
the
running.
The champ is here. The champ is here. Where the fuck get them shades?
Let's cut off your braid today just for the pod. It'll be lit.
Where'd you get them shades?
None of that. Gotta wear gloves, dude.
Are those the new Reeboks you got? Those are actually pretty sick.
Yeah, we're on. You brought your UFC gloves? Throw them on.
Yeah. Oh, shit. I had mine in my slingshot. I threw them out in the garage earlier. What the fuck you snacking on? Some peanut M&M's?
Yeah, I'm so hungry,
dude. Those will fill you up.
Hungry for nutrition.
Hungry. Those are actually pretty sick shorts. Those Reebok ones. Dude, I'm so curious.
You can go no shirt if you want. It don't fucking matter.
Yeah, I don't even wear a shirt. I wonder what Venom's going to do with like
when does
shoes.
That come out?
Isn't it January or some shit?
Oh, the new year, huh?
The fuck Venom's is that? Is that some wizard shit?
That's his thing he goes to the park with his sword buddies. Sword spice.
I can hear you.
That's true.
That's
talk
funny.
About it, be about it. I like talking about it and just really not being about it.
I be I mean? About it sometimes. All right, peace.
All right, see you, Kyle.
Kyle.
There you go. Frank said he was walking at Sprouts the other day carrying his basket, and he said he hit that fucking nerve and he felt that shock down his foot. He was like, what the fuck? And I'm like, dude, I believe
that's
it.
That's funny.
I was thinking, how many kicks recently, since my fight in the last whatever, how many weeks, how many leg kicks there has been? And not that hasn't happened once again. I'm like, that was so fucking just
weird.
It was. It's just so.
Well, just like Frost.
But he meant to do that.
Thousand.
He meant to kick that. That's the thing that's sweet. It was skill.
Yeah, but he meant to kick you with his shin.
I know,
but
I was
he pulled
kidding.
Out.
He meant
I don't
to
know.
Kick that. There's no way you try to. I'm going to kick someone's nerve.
That was just brutal. Dude, buy me a sandwich or something. Rich,
yeah, give me 20
guy.
Bucks. Fucking 50 G's, boy.
Who's
I can get avocado.
Who's been hitting you up now that you won the 50 G's? Anyone?
All the chicks.
Really?
Yep.
When you buy them diamond
just
rings?
Just slaying out butt.
No, I don't even like the butt.
Dude, just go get some fucking ice. Spend all your money.
I might, dude.
Where'd you sleep last night? At Tempe?
On a park. On a bench.
That's the mic. You can swing it around.
Yeah. I slept in my girlfriend's place.
Because that's right, like, right close to us.
Them shades are lit. It's
fun. Yeah.
What color? I mean, what brand?
Closer, I got these.
Those are some shit. Or
I have the... I have the actual Gucci ones that are like $500.
See?
But these ones I got at Target for like $14.
Bro, remember, those look like Gucci.
Remember when you bought your Versaces?
$340 or some shit? Oh, I broke them. Long time ago.
Dude, no injuries?
No injuries.
That's bullshit.
Holy shit. So was that trip over there fucking sweet?
It was tight. I mean, and two, you can't, dude, like you, I guess in Dubai, yeah, I tried the, these are pretty good.
Yeah, I like them.
Yeah. No.
He throws in. These are pretty good. You
can't no, watch dude. Porn?
Yeah, so you can't watch porn, that's and it's illegal. You'll go to jail, you know? So,
did you want to just kind of test it out a little
so
bit?
So I liked it out there, you know? I got everything I wanted, man. Uh-huh.
But you could enjoy yourself anywhere, pretty much.
Yeah, and all the other people that were there, they're like, oh, we don't like it here. And I'm like, why not? And I figured out it's because they can't watch porn.
That's right. Yeah.
And they have addiction problems, man. Those people, I got to pray for them, man.
For sure.
It's like, dude.
There's one thing to do is pray.
You're looking at an addiction right there. When it comes
bullshit. Addiction. You have orange, do you have orange pea bears or what?
No, they're black.
No? Black?
That's
they're
kinda,
black. They're black with just red stripes. What about stripes. Yours?
Post it on Patreon. Rainbow? I have a little curly.
Rainbow?
Mine are rainbow. Mine are get a little curls.
But, sweet. Dude, you guys eat good out there and shit?
So good, dude.
They had unlimited
just trifecta
food?
Or what?
Trifecta, like leading up to the fight, and then right after everything, dude. They had a lot of like really high end restaurants.
Oh, mm-hmm.
And dude, like I had so much pasta and chicken fried rice.
You so know you recommend I mean? Fighting out there if we could?
Yeah, it's a different experience. It's yeah, like, it seems dude, cool. It's so cool, bro. Being at the beach and you can go on jet skis. I wanted to go on the jetpack. They have that jetpack thing, but I didn't. We weren't able to because of the time.
So how much were the jet skis to rent?
It was like. I don't know if it's dirhams, but it's translated. It's like $40 for an hour.
Damn, I bet that was fun.
You can do an hour. You can do.
Did Crouch get on one?
Crouch got on one. Marcus,
Nico,
Nico didn't.
Why,
dude? I don't know why. He's like, I'm just gonna stay here. Chris Curry also stopped. Like he had the fastest one, the blue one, and it like stopped. And then so he was stuck out there for a little bit.
Damn it, I would have cruised up and grabbed Nico.
Yeah, Persian Gulf, dude. We're driving right by Ferrari World. We couldn't go there, but like we were, you know, going by it on the jet skis. And then there was like, I saw some roller coasters. There's a sick ass golf course.
So as soon as you get there and land, they test you. And then you quarantine for how long?
Dude, I got tested 6 times. I got a new bracelet, different colors. I should have collected them.
You should have.
I threw them away. There's a gold one. You got the pink one, the green one, the blue one, the red one.
So you get tested 3 times in Vegas and then 3 times in Abu Dhabi?
No. I like once or twice in Vegas and then the rest in Dubai.
And the flight, how long was the flight?
The flight was 14 hours, but you man, dude, it's sick, dude. You get first class.
Did you beat off and beat
No, man. Holly Holm was sitting next to me.
So you had respect.
I'm not going to do that, you know?
But can you make it private if you want on there?
Yeah, you can shut it. I have a door.
You did beat off. Just be honest.
No, I didn't, dude. I passed out. I, like, was drinking right after my fight.
We were going before.
Dude, right before we went to the pool, me and Casey, and then we were just, like, drinking a couple beers. Because we only had, like, 2 hours till we had to get to the airport. Mm-hmm. So we all just got to the airport, dude. I'm in the bus, right? And I'm in the bus. And I was like...
Oh.
I was like, I threw up in the bus, like right next to Crouch's feet, and then like, dude, Chris Curry also is super cool. He's like, fuck you guys. He's like putting people off. It was tight, dude. Got there, ate a bunch of Persian food, got on the plane. I passed out and woke up. I had the brand new like Fight Island T-shirt. Mm-hmm. Passed out, woke up with like lamb meat on my thing, dude. And I was like, oh my gosh, what is wrong with me?
You're talking about on the way back?
Yeah, on the way back.
So then Casey.
Stayed?
I thought Casey stayed.
No, he's in Vegas right now.
Oh, okay, so he came back to Vegas.
And then he's going back again, yeah.
Fuck.
Damn, so is he training in Vegas, or is he coming here to train for a little bit?
He went to the PI to get his aura ring. Did you get that?
They're giving out aura rings?
What?
I've had mine for years.
Really? I'm going to go get one tomorrow. I'm going to Vegas tomorrow.
Grab me one.
I wonder if he can. You can call. You could probably call him and pick it up for him, but...
Yeah.
Does
that thing work?
I've literally been using it for years.
Really?
Yeah.
You like it?
I track my sleep every night, yeah.
I just want an excuse to ditch practice.
Yeah, for sure. Not work hard.
Sorry, coach. My ring tells me
I can't. Well, dude, you deserve it.
Are you going to train with us Friday?
I'm going to be in Vegas.
Oh, okay.
next week.
So Casey Kinney fucking when did he get? When did they say, "Hey, you can fight in Abu Dhabi"? Was it there, or did he come back and then they said?
Yeah, he took the fight against Nathaniel Wood.
Yeah, when?
Right after the fight, not right after, but maybe like 2 hours later.
Shelby said, "Hey, you want this one?"
I think Jason House.
Okay, sweet. Mm. Fuck. What if they had said something to you? Would you said, "Fuck yeah"?
No. I got some things I gotta like fix. A couple little tweaks.
Did you fuck Nathaniel
from the
up?
Beginning of the year that I need to go check out? That I just completely forgot about, you know.
Taxes.
Yeah. I feel you.
Damn, that's crazy. So Casey just gets to stay there with Chris Cariasso and train until, because it's two more weeks even.
Yeah.
Right?
It's pretty much not even a camp. His foot, did you see that? His fight?
Mm-mm. Oh, his fight?
Oh, I watched his fight.
Bro, did you see the guy's ribs?
Yeah, I was fucked.
Dude, he destroyed that guy. He set the record. I think it might have been second. I'm not sure if it's first or second, but set the record for most body kicks. And the person that has the record was a 5-round fight.
I literally got to your house, I think, when it was round 3 and he had landed like fucking 30. I was like, Jesus.
How'd that little fucker stay up? That guy that was getting kicked.
It's Mongolians, dude.
It looked like his shit was caved in.
Yeah.
It was fucking gnarly. But then
sour sauce. Dude. So yeah. Chinese food.
Yep. Where were you and Marcus sitting when you found out you got another 50?
50 G's.
Dude, I don't even care if it gets 50. But I know.
Sugar's the same way. He doesn't care that much. Then I think the nice thing about
it's
50
sick
G's,
as fuck. It's amazing, you know? But
well, the thing is, it covers all your bills. You can pay, the gym.
It does.
You can pay fucking house. And
taxes.
Then yeah, all that
it
shit.
It does.
It's nice.
Yeah. I feel like every time I go into a fight, I expect it, and I try not to, but I'm like,
yeah.
I added on.
Your guys' style.
Mentally, I'm like, okay, I'm going to make this much, plus 50. That last fight, I was like, shit, I did not make what I plan on making. It was all good.
Fuck it, bro. Knock that next dude out, you know?
Or not.
All that will be gone, dude.
Or not. No, that'll be
fine. No, man, it'll all be gone.
Nice. When did you really feel with that kid? Because I told Sugar, I said, that kid's going to come out hot in the first round. Because Sugar called you finish him in the first.
I tweeted Kyler first round finish.
I'm like, Kyler's going to.
Thanks, bro.
I felt like you were going to feel him out second round, open up a little bit. But, dude, I bet that kid was like, motherfucker, on top. All that work with Taquinho too, all that half guard stuff, passing the guard, and you dominated that motherfucker.
You see when he turned, I was already in the back so
that was
quick.
Sick.
I went for that twister. It would have been sick if I got it. I would have got a bonus. No, but for
rub
real,
it
dude.
In, bud.
Yeah,
no shucks.
Gotta land one of those.
No, but your jiu-jitsu looks sick. When you took his back, that was fucking tight.
Elbows. And you just, I was like, I bet this kid's looking at you because he's jacked, tattoos. He's looking at you like a soft little.
He had that lion thing, but once I jumped out there, dude, I was like a ninja turtle, bro.
You should have
bigger, scary. Man. Yeah. And then I got in his face after I flipped, and I was like, "What's up, boy? What's up?"
Because I saw that
at the weigh-ins. He's a really cool dude. I talked to him after. Yeah.
Excited for yellow.
I was watching his highlights all week, or not all week, but I didn't know who was fighting, so like.
Because you went to Abu Dhabi not having an opponent, right?
Yeah.
Because you got pulled out.
Once I left and got on the plane, I had that. Finally got the fight with him. But I didn't watch anything. I just took the fight. I was like, yeah, take it. And then the guy had some sick knockouts. And they said he was a brown belt in jiu-jitsu. And then he's putting dudes to sleep. And so I'm like, okay.
Perfect.
Maybe he's going to try to get that right. And I tried to take him down. He's going to try to grab my neck. So I was very weary and stuff like that. But I started just feeling that energy, man. I was like,
how patient you were was just so fucking prime, dude. Hitting
those angles.
Didn't rush anything.
Yeah. I was talking to Mario yesterday. I was like, dude, that's fucking crazy because me, you, and Mario all were amateurs at the lab around the same time. What the?
No.
All amateurs at the same time. Now we're all in the UFC, all getting bonuses.
Yeah.
Fucking 20, we're all 25, 26, 20, yeah. Whatever.
It's
just fucking crazy
sweet.
How that worked out.
So how was your weight cut? When you left Vegas, what'd you weigh?
So my initial weight cut was good, but I've been in the past couple, three fights have been easy. I always make weight easy. I only do 6 to 8 pounds. And
the week of 6 to 8?
No, for the water cut.
Oh, okay.
And like... this time was I cut a little bit more, dude, and it was fine. But I cut a little bit more because I was scheduled to fight in June, and then like July. I tried fighting in August, September, and I kept so going in and out of camp.
Oh,
yeah.
Like it's like the effect of like when you're cutting more, then you bounce up more. And so like after like three of those times within 3 months, my weight was like 2, 3, maybe 4 pounds heavier. Yeah. And at the end, that water's even a pound is a lot. You know?
That's what happened in my last camp. I think I was just a little bit heavier, but I'd cut weight in March, fought in June, and then made weight in August, and I felt like that last cut was just a little yeah. bit harder. Not too much harder, but it was.
Yeah, that's why I don't lift weights as much, and I'll do focus more on cardio. It helps with the weight cut.
So what kind of – how good and disciplined are you with your diet out of fight camp?
Pretty good now.
Are you?
I was just learning, like, trifecta helps a lot of meal prepping and stuff. Mm-hmm. I've been doing more meal prepping at home, which has been helping a lot.
Because all fight camp now, Trifecta will send you guys stuff, right?
Yeah.
Which is fucking huge. And it's organic shit.
Yeah. I need to find a sponsor for like a meal prep out of camp. That would be cool.
I don't know about Trifecta, but.
Because it's whenever you go out to eat and you get these double portions and then like you're waiting and then it's just your metabolism. That's all it is.
Well, then, unless you're in Scottsdale, it's hard to eat organic food when we're here in Glendale, like Phoenix area. There's not a lot of organic restaurants.
Sprouts, yeah.
But because you joined my Warzone party, I think right when you guys landed in Abu Dhabi, were the rooms pimping?
Oh yeah.
You brought your Xbox?
Yeah. Dude, but the Wi-Fi was weak.
Oh. It always is at the motels.
Yeah, the Wi-Fi was weak, man. I'm gonna get a PC, a gaming PC now.
That's gonna be tight.
Yeah. Just because I just want a PC. Been wanting for a while.
I think I'm gonna do the new Xbox. X, right?
Really?
I have no idea.
Xbox X.
Do you have a gaming PC?
I just have an Xbox One right now. Mm.
See, that's the thing is, if I get an Xbox or a new one, then it's just going to be the new Xbox in a couple years, the new PS4.
Well, you get a PC,
at least you keep it. Yeah, but at least you can keep like playing new, like all the games.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, and now all the games are compatible with PC, aren't they?
Yeah. Most of them.
The PS5 was like a grand, isn't it?
I don't know.
I think so.
Or just get the Oculus.
What the hell is that?
Like the VR.
The porn.
This thing makes me dizzy.
Sugar and I were talking about that fucking that American horror story. It's American Nightmare or something, murder story on Netflix.
Oh really?
What the fuck happened? Yeah, that show is
the most fucked up Chinese show. Dude. It's number one on Netflix right now. It's the most fucked up show I've ever seen.
You cocksucker.
Yeah.
It's the number one. If you watch that on Netflix?
American Horror Story?
No, the American Murder Story. It's the
neighbor.
Or
the next door neighbor or some shit.
It's the most fucked. I don't want to break it to everyone, but it's on Netflix. It just came out. It's the most. I wish I wouldn't have watched
Halloween,
it.
Halloween, dude.
Really? I've never wanted to kill somebody so bad in my fucking life, dude. It will make you sick to your stomach.
But it's probably good, dude, because. We live in
that's
a,
it.
We
it's
live in
American
a fucked
murder.
Up world,
well,
man.
Danny and I were walking last night, and I'm like, we do not know what's going on in any of these fucking houses. You just don't.
This one will trip you out. You'll be like, are you fucking?
Does it show
me?
The trial and stuff?
Oh yeah.
Oh, see, I've
there's
seen
the
that.
Most footage.
Dude,
like,
is
live
he killed
footage.
His family or something?
Well, like, I'm not gonna say. Anything.
Yeah, we're not gonna break it. But sociopaths are fucking crazy. Like, sometimes I think I'm a sociopath when it comes to some things, but, like, the level of sociopath there are out there.
Well, they
like,
say it's in us all.
Do they?
I forget what that was, but that
Philippians
3:13. The murder, the.
No.
The killer. It's in us all. All that fucked up shit in every one of us.
It's just the human brain, dude. It's so weird how, like, people you wouldn't even know.
Mm.
You would never even expect. Their brain thinks a different way, but they don't say it.
Oh.
You know? And, like,
well, the thing is, too,
your life is shaped by your thoughts.
For sure.
100%.
100%.
Oh. Well, the thing is, too, when I see someone I fucking, like, dislike or someone who's just fucking crazy, I'm like, dude. If I was raised exactly like them with their genes, I'd be the same way. So how can you be that mad at that person?
Yeah. It's tough.
Yeah.
You would. Think of anyone. If you were raised their exact same way.
Jeffrey Epstein.
Same genes.
Seek to understand. Yeah. Not to be understood or whatever the hell that goes.
Ayy.
But if fucking... Do you have a meditation type practice or do you just use that when you're training?
What do you
as
mean?
Your meditation type practice?
I do both closed eye meditation and as well as open eye meditation. And I think open eye meditation is the most important. That's like the application.
Well, that's fucking hard.
Like doing it in your everyday activities, like having that same enthusiasm, just mopping the floor, just being present. Yeah. You know, like not just.
I like the little post Brandon sent us yesterday. Mm-hmm. The one, this is what it said in a book, Sugar Strength Condition Coach.
Where's Clay, dude?
This one says, you've probably heard the saying, life's about the journey, not the destination. Yet many of us are waiting for some goal to be reached, some status to be attained before we can begin enjoying our lives. We say things to ourselves like, I will be happy when I get this job, accumulate this amount of money, and have this relationship. There is nothing wrong with wanting to attain or achieve certain things, but if we make our happiness conditional on reaching certain destination points, our life will become a series of goals to obtain, with each one failing to deliver the promise of happiness we envisioned. Living this way means missing out on the beauty of the journey, the one that is happening right now. Happiness can only be found in the present moment, not at some imaginary place in the future.
Yeah, happiness is a choice, dude. It's true. A choice, dude. People put it on other people, like,
or status or shit to be attained. It's like, yeah. Man, once I get this, and it never fucking ends.
And I feel like we're becoming robots, like the way everything is designed. We're becoming robotic with mentality, these things,
dude.
It's our next,
dude. We're just
evolution.
Life is to share, not compare, and we're like literally becoming the opposite, and we're becoming robots, dude.
Well, dude, we're evolving.
And our mindsets is not organic. I like the organic mentality is the one where you're like. Is what we're supposed to be, you know, being whatever it is. You're like animal nature. Like, that's what it is, dude. You're not going to be perfect. Like, yeah. You're going to mess up, you know. Like, you're still loved no matter what, you know.
Well, it's crazy when you wake up, too, automatically, like, somewhere in your brain, you're wanting to check your emails. You want to check your phone. Want to check it. You're wanting some fucking stimulation. These fucking phones are so freakishly addicting. It's not even funny.
Oof.
Social dilemma. The social dilemma, I think,
it's
right?
It's a drug.
Who do you want to see Colby fight next? Jorge, Burns, Usman.
Not
Nick
Usman.
Or Nate.
I want to see him fight Burns. Oh, that would
dude.
Be tight.
Burns not, would be sweet. Not Nick or Nate.
Too easy.
Too fucking easy, yeah. Dude.
Usman, it's just... Usman's just not like a star.
Yeah.
Burns isn't either, but... His fucking skill
like
set
scrap,
is
dude.
So sick.
Just want to see scraps. Like
Colby's not going to really, I feel like, out-grapple Gilbert.
No, fuck no. There's no.
And I want to like see that level not. Of jiu-jitsu Ooh, against that level of wrestling.
Dude.
Yeah.
And then, but Jorge would be an interesting matchup too.
Well, dude, Jorge went to Abu Dhabi, took that fight on 7 days fucking notice, probably was training a little bit, but... You watch all Jorge's YouTube vlogs. He's not that disciplined.
That's my big brother, dude.
And maybe in fight camp he's more disciplined, but he went and shut down a lot of Usman's shots that fight.
Yeah.
A lot. And with a full fight camp.
Versus Colby would be sick because, dude, he could take Colby's head off. Colby throws his striking. It's good, but it's not like Jorge's where it's more. It's real fucking hard kickball.
Yeah.
Boom, boom, boom. Colby's more like shoot, boom, 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 up and down,
changing
which
levels,
is fucking
yeah.
scary and high level.
Yeah.
For sure. It's, dude, that'd be a sick fight. Colby's one of my – when it comes to entertainment, he's one of my favorite fighters.
Yeah.
Now. Because the last, what, 3 years?
Oh, because he's white?
Whatever he says, you want him to see him just push to the fucking limits
yeah,
of what he
yeah.
says.
Yeah, he does say some crazy stuff.
He does.
Did you see that Mike Perry saying, hey, whoever pays me the most amount of money can be in my corner?
And he's up to 5,000. Should we go? Oh, it's up to 10 now?
10 G's, a
porn
star.
Porn star Kendra Luss offers Darren Till work.
Yeah, 10 G's
Mike Perry.
To be in his corner.
Why?
And Darren Till is offering money too. But
this is crazy, man.
Well, dude, 10 grand's... selling your corner spot, that's a way to make money on sponsors. Reebok's going to give you, what, 2,500 fucking bucks?
4,000.
I'll put Steven Seagal on my corner.
That'd be sick.
So how much would you sell when your corner spots for? I'm saying, do 10 grand.
Sell to Baker or what?
Put the boots. I don't care. 10 G's, I'd say, all right. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, shit, you don't need 3.
Yeah, you don't.
It depends. Depends.
amount of comfortability. Yeah, but fucking Mike Perry. So he's going to have his girl and this porn star in his corner against Robbie Lawler.
That's ridiculous, bro.
Watch him win.
Watch him go and fucking
That's actually, you know what? They're like finding ways around it to make money without with the Reebok deal. Yeah. That's cool.
That's what Sugar was talking about, the Venom.
They're evolving, bro. Fighters are evolving, dude.
Or devolving.
Yeah, or devolving Mike Perry.
No, look at that guy.
I love Mike Perry.
I love Mike Perry, too. His girl's cute.
He's fucking fun to watch. He's entertaining as fuck. He's a fucking pit bull.
And he's emotional.
He's a fucking human pit bull.
That guy, dude.
Dana, what do you got for current events?
Nothing too crazy.
Big Trump got the corona.
Yeah, exactly.
That's bullshit. It's fake.
He was in and out in 3 days.
So you haven't had the corona yet?
Oh, I had it like way back. I never got tested for it, but I'm pretty sure I had it.
Yeah.
And then I've gotten tested like 20 times.
I wonder if the strain's gotten fucking weaker, dude. Because literally the whole everything shut down. The whole country shut down. People lost their businesses. People's lives got fucked for a flu.
They said that it's been evolving worse.
It's been getting stronger.
Yeah. It's pretty messed up, dude. What's going on?
Is it though? Because I've been way sicker than that, dude. It's messed up that they shut down everything.
Yeah, just the whole...
Yeah.
New York to impose new shutdown in Corona hotspots.
So they're like shutting down everything again. Like schools, everything is like getting shut down in New York again.
And they're thinking about shutting down Vegas again.
Dude, I just want the fans back.
Yeah.
I want the fans in the crowd. I watched the Habib versus Conor thing on Fight Pass, the Emmy award winning fucking whatever.
Uh-huh.
And just seeing the fans there, I teared up. Legit, I was like, what the fuck? Just watching that and seeing just Habib, just the fans, and it's just fucking different, dude.
It's a fucking different energy.
It is.
For sure. I felt that way last week. Like, I usually, like, my last fight, not this one, but the one before, I was like, it felt so good, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And this one now, main card, you know? It's like, you make the main card, your second fight, I go out there, and I'm ready to go. But, like, the walk was short.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And like I could do that thing, and then it's like it was cool, and then I was still hyped, but
it is still cool.
Marcus and me were talking about it too, and I feel like with less of a crowd, it becomes more personal with you and that person in the octagon.
Yeah,
it felt more personal because it's like less people. It's like in a, it's like you're in a dark alley with
more
a person.
Intimate almost.
But if there's a bunch of people, it's more about like the event.
Everyone's screaming.
Yeah.
Love that.
It's definitely a different feel, but like I said, I think it's, especially for newcomers to the UFC, I think it's better for them because when you walk out the first time in the UFC, you walk out of that tunnel and that energy just goes, woof, that's where people are like, oh my God.
That's so fun though. I love that too. Feeling. Oh my
Yeah,
gosh.
Both you guys rise up to it.
And
so
there's
going to
be
well.
Dudes, I don't know when this corona thing is, I don't know when they're going to start introducing crowds, but like. There's going to be people in there with like 3, 4, 5 fights in the UFC and have never fought for the UFC with a crowd.
Yeah, for sure.
They never got that feeling.
For sure, dude.
You know?
Second debate's happening tonight.
Hey, is it? Dude, what time? You know what time?
Oh, okay. So it's not the big boys, Trump and Biden.
But it's going to be sick.
Is it?
Remind me tonight at 5 p.m. to watch the debate. I gotta remember that shit.
I wonder what big Trump he's doing. Cause I hit up
beating off
for. Cause I hit up my friend who's a doctor, Dr. Carlos, and I said, "Hey, can you get me some hydroxychloroquine? Does that wipe it out quicker so I can get back?" And he said, "Dude, if your symptoms aren't bad, just ride it out. Hydroxychloroquine is if your symptoms are really bad, it might help. Cause that's what Schwab did.
Yeah,
and it got out of him in like 3 days.
But viruses are crazy.
How the fuck did Trump get it? Hookers. And his girl.
Fucking some holes.
Yeah. His girl's pretty sexy, though.
She is.
Yeah, but when you're Donald Trump.
True.
With that hairstyle.
Yeah.
That's and that tan.
Big schlong.
Oh, yeah.
That stretch.
Oh, yeah.
Did you go see his little, like, hype video when he came back? I thought it was pretty funny.
What about?
No, is it safe?
Is this it?
It's like 37 seconds, and it's just, like, him coming back from the hospital.
Bullshit.
Oh. Just like a hero.
It's
epic, dude.
This is
lit. I should have done one of these in my Prius coming back to my house.
You never left your house. Did he post this?
Yeah, he posted it.
He's got a bitch on each side, too. That'd be tight.
He rips the mask off, like, all epic.
Punts it.
This is sick. I'm back, baby.
I'm back, baby.
It's weird because, like, it seems kind of funny, but it, like, truly is inspirational.
What? Dropping this off Trump. I liked when that guy said in the debate, he said, the moderator or whatever, said, let him finish, and Biden says, that'll never happen, and Donald Trump said, you'd be surprised.
I know.
Or something like, or he said he's not good at that. He said, you'd be surprised.
He just goes in his place and calls
That's
Colby.
That's the debate.
Yeah.
That's the debate. I love it.
That was fucking sweet.
I don't know if you guys like rock music,
but... What the?
Oh, shit.
R.I.P.
cancer?
Peace.
Yeah.
R.I.P. That's a sick fucking pick right there.
Damn, that fucker croaked,
and
huh?
Wildfires.
Go up.
Holy shit.
Dude, and that's so just 6, like a normal 000? Fucking, not normal that much, but yeah. Every summer now, it's just like a normal thing.
Dude. Well, just like Trump was talking about, in other countries, they have fucking way more shit that starts on fire, but they just handle it better. 6,000.
How much percentage of that is like the pyros?
I don't know.
Yeah, there's.
You think is that still from the fucking baby announcement thing?
Pyros?
Yeah. Yeah, this is.
That's still from the baby announcement, the gender reveal.
From like a bunch of different fires.
Oh, okay.
6,250 square miles.
Ugh. It's crazy. It's almost 2021 already.
I think, well, yeah, what are we, like 80% through the year? I follow this thing on Twitter that shows you that. But, dude, imagine how bad the air is in California now.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Remember that one time we went to San Fran and we were walking down and we were like, oh, we're in like a bad part.
I thought we were gonna get jumped.
Because I did too. I was legitimately
was the gay part?
Scared. No.
My little brother goes to college there.
It was like gangsters, and we're just two white boys, the only ones, I feel like.
Yeah. I just pulled my hat down, put my
E40. They thought he was E40.
From the Bay, getting hypey.
I just started walking gay.
But I was getting ready to run and scream.
Me too.
Dude.
But then there was bums on the streets just injecting themselves, huh?
Yeah, that was sad. That was fucking
when
crazy.
I went over there one time, I went out there and like, dude, I seen some guy just walk up the street, just so obvious, pass a bag.
Oh,
walk off like
you just point and yell drugs.
Drugs.
just gotta pray for them, man.
Dude, yeah, that shit sucks.
You doing some sober October? Or what's your schedule like when it comes to the cannabis?
I went to the dispensary in Vegas.
Hey,
Reef?
I'm not sure. I went with Marcus. Mm-hmm. Smoked a couple joints to the face.
After for celebration?
Yeah, with Casey. So we all had our own. Felt pretty sick. Just puffing. Yeah.
I bet that was a good trip because, dude, when you're with a buddy, you guys both win, get your checks, you guys are healthy. There's nothing better.
Yeah, it was fun. We were just walking around, but it was weird, man. Like
Vegas,
dude, like the bars.
Yeah,
like you have to like every time people would get drinks, and then they were like, you have to like pull up your mask, drink it, and put it back down. Like every time you'll be having your drink in your hand, and you pull your mask down to
talk. In the casinos,
the guy would come up and be like. Put your mask up. And it's like, how am I going to drink and do this at the same time? And it's weird because, like, the whole socializing is so awkward. And then, like, so the chicks are evolving now, you know? So now everything has to be more dance moves. You know, everything has to be more visual.
With chicks?
Yeah.
Dude, it's hard with chicks, dude.
It is.
With the Tinder and Bumble and that shit and those filters, the chicks look so prime. And then in real life, they're just so awkward.
I never thought about that until you brought that up. They're scared you're not going to think they're hot because they've been sending you filtered pics.
And same for me. I filter out my zits on my chest.
How? Just swipe.
Dude, swipe couple.
That's why it's better to just come clean. You know what I mean? Yeah. Come straight out
the box. Here's my fucking flaws.
This is you. And then everything from there is all uphill.
So here's it's one, true. And then you get a pick. I get a filter.
So say
next.
When you're single, what's your go-to like pickup line for a girl?
I don't know. I haven't been single in a while, bro.
That's true.
Actually...
Actually, a couple months.
No, I'm not really the Tinder guy, though, man. I like meeting people in person,
going out
more
to
physical interaction.
You're pretty social. You like going out.
Yeah,
see, Tim and I can't. We're we go out to girls and we're like, I haven't been out of the house in a couple of days.
Overthink it, like, dude. Fuck. Overthink it.
I played Warzone for 6 hours.
Yeah.
Hey, you doing?
No, some chicks are weird, bro.
Just moving your hands.
Hoping
like
they have a redhead fetish.
They See, do. Yeah, that's,
some do.
They yeah, do. I know a lot of guys with redhead fetishes for chicks, so it's got to be the opposite for chicks.
Sometimes.
You'd think. Sometimes. Tim likes peeing on girls, too, I heard.
Really? I never tried that.
No, I joked. But that's some people do.
Oh, I know. It's fucking weird. That's such a weird... Fetishes are a weird thing.
That's the world we live in, dude.
It is. There was this Brazilian on Fightmaster. He just would say, my dream is to have a girl shit on my chest.
And he was serious?
He was dead serious. That's my my dream, and that's my fetish.
Brazilians are weird, man.
Brazilians. They just put them all in that category. They all like that. No, that's
crazy. Have you ever heard of the reptilian elite theory? Will you Google that and see what that is?
Birds aren't real.
Birds aren't
real? Dude, there's a new thing. Dude, there's this new thing my girls tell me. Birds aren't real. It's like a new group, like a social thing, dude. I saw that.
What are they?
Basically, you know how birds, they go on the landlines or like those cords? That's where they charge. And they just think that the birds are government watching. And they charge on those.
Well, dude, anymore you see some of those like those new mosquitoes that fly around and they have cameras? That's some crazy shit, too. I might buy one.
You're a freak.
Yeah, that is. I mean, well.
You're just
dude,
a freak.
What is a freak now? You know what I mean?
Yeah, exactly.
I don't, it's like, yeah, that's I don't mind being a freak.
Everybody's so freak.
Everyone's a freak. Closet freak. Yeah. Guaranteed.
Not my mom or dad.
Oh, God, the worst.
They're Christians.
That's true.
Yeah, that's... See, that's the thing, too, is you gotta come clean, bro.
You gotta come clean. Just let everyone know you're fucking
Don't let... Mom. Don't come clean.
No, hide that shit. Hide
you gotta
shit.
Filter it.
Filter that shit.
The moment you put a label on yourself is when you... It's just... It screws everything up.
I like hanging out with my friends. I don't have to filter myself. Elite reptiles. Yeah. Those are the people I enjoy hanging out with.
Yeah. The world's hard to
believe. Dude... It's so weird, like my older brother, well, just people when they think of famous people, they think that they're like this, controlled by a group, like Katy Perry. It's like she just got famous as fuck. Justin Bieber got famous as fuck because they're like good they're, as fuck
they
at
sold
what they're
their
doing.
Souls.
And they just, people attracted to them. It's that fucking simple, but they're like, no, it can't be.
Yeah, Illuminati, cult stuff. Dude, that stuff's real, bro.
Is
some
it?
Of it is, some of it's not. We don't know. That's the thing.
It's like everything. There's reality and
well,
non-reality.
Jeffrey Epstein.
Everything.
That guy was fucking wild. Whatever happened to that? That was like the biggest thing. And then the Ghislaine Maxwell got arrested, and now it's just gone.
Well, and then COVID came.
Oh.
And then it just got disappeared.
They're like, we need to cover this up. Let's start a virus.
Damn, I wonder if that was it.
This reptilian. Do you think the reptile thing is more of a concept, a spiritual thing, or like? Like a dark underworld thing?
Well,
or
remember,
is it like straight up physical? Like they have reptile heads.
Remember the Alex Jones spirit. When he, Joe Rogan was talking about Alex Jones saw all the higher ups in like worshiping the, what was it? An owl? Burning an owl and they were all wearing shit like that. Kyler, you're one of them, brother.
Come clean.
Come clean. No, they were all wearing shit like that though and worshiping the burning owl. And Alex Jones snuck in with a camera and recorded it. Idiot.
Dude, I like listening to Alex Jones.
Well, he got canceled, didn't he? He's
passionate.
Yeah.
I think he got canceled. Like, they took his shit down. They took him off YouTube.
Well, do you ever heard of Daily Motions? It's like a
video
YouTube
source,
thing,
right?
But it's like not censored at all. Like YouTube,
I haven't.
You can't see porn. Daily Motions has fucked up things.
Did they really?
You ever watch like beheading videos?
They have that shit, yeah.
No, yeah, it's messed up, dude. It just shows you that's where we live.
It is crazy.
That is literally like, that's where we live, bro.
That kind of shit freaks me out. But then I watched that Netflix documentary yesterday and I'm like, I would love to behead that guy. He deserves to be beheaded.
Or does he deserve forgiveness?
That's true. It would the higher person be like, forgive?
They would.
Oh, it's such a fucking evil person, though.
Daily Motion. Yeah, the video. Yeah, just like click on it. It's just like a YouTube, but it's it has like beheadings and ISIS
and
shit
and stuff. Ugh.
Ugh. Yeah.
I was watching a documentary on HBO, or I think it was Showtime or something. Osama bin Laden's life, and he had a compound with kids there.
Hashtag goals.
And it was just really shut off from the outside. And he was super smart, so he wouldn't even search the internet. He wouldn't get on there because people could encrypt his information and find him. But it's a weird thing because they found his computer and they got his computer and they got all the files, all the videos that were uploaded. And porn's illegal in that country too, but they had porn on the computer.
Bullshit.
And it was just like, it's a pretty crazy thing.
pretty
crazy. Dark web. Have you guys ever been on the dark web?
I have.
How do you get there?
You got to download Taurus. You have to download that. Remember we downloaded it on that laptop? What was that?
And I started getting scared a little bit.
Well, we were going to order some drugs.
Some Ollies?
We were going to order some Ollies. No, I don't know. But we were going to see how...
Dude, I've never been on the dark web.
You got to go.
You got to poke around a little bit.
Just poke around.
If you get a little too deep, just back up a little bit.
No, that's...
Get a little deep, keep to yourself.
Yeah, but it's crazy. They said 80% of the web is dark, the dark, deep web. 20% is like Google and all
well,
the
remember
shit
that, what was that cop show that the lady would go to sleep and the husband was a cop and you'd get in the dark web and talk
about
killing his wife and stuff. But he
what?
That one was good.
Well, killing his wife, cooking her, making a soup out of her and stuff. Like
it and was, her friends.
Yeah, it was in this little fetish group chat.
I don't understand, bro.
A forum. Like, you never will. And I think it's pointless to try to understand and just know that we can't.
It's just sick. It's just sickness. It's being fucking sick in the head when it gets to that.
But like, could you imagine yourself trying to think those thoughts or like trying to like?
I could see. I
making
could see
a little human soup.
But just keep going on and like making this thing, becoming obsessed with it. And like, like
they might arrive.
It's like
you
what?
Slice them in the butt.
I know it's weird.
We all have fucked up thoughts, but it's if you let them just carry on.
That's just a different level. That's got to be like reptiles. That's got to be with some AI stuff, dude.
When my parents got divorced, my dad moved to these apartments in Great Falls. It was kind of a hoodish place. Two blocks away, about 2 months later, a guy got arrested there because he was chopping up a kid and putting him in his stew and bringing it to events and having human stew.
Like Tim's stew?
Yeah. It could have been a little red. Stew? It could have been me with ease.
Ease.
Dude, that's messed up, bro. Yeah.
So when are you thinking? You want to get probably booked again, maybe January, February-ish?
Yeah, whenever. Yeah, I'm going to get some things checked out, maybe December, January, February.
That'd be lit.
But hell yeah.
Before the year.
Dude, now, especially at the lab and then with training with Taquinho and training with our little grappling group.
Dude.
You got, and Nico, it's like.
It's inspiring, bro.
We got a good spot here in Phoenix to get world champs, like turn you motherfuckers.
I just want
to
get better, bro. Even that last fight, I'm like. It just shows like, oh man, like I want to get like level up my jiu-jitsu game, level up my wrestling, level up my my striking, level up my speed,
it's nice
my
when
power.
It feels like it's like oh, it pays off going out there and performing like that. And you're like, fuck yes, all the shit I'm doing is good shit. It's working. This is right. This is what I need to be doing more of.
Well, it's the worst too when it doesn't, and you did do everything.
I know
that's the fucking worst.
Yeah. I know.
So
I
when did you did you start jiu-jitsu? What age were you again?
I was three, but I wasn't serious. I was always laughing, dude. Like, my dad would – I learned the armbar from Mount, you know, because we were at the Grace Academy and stuff. And I was just a little spazzy ADD kid. I got ADD or ADHD, but, like
– Or HIV or whatever.
Or, like, yeah, just
– Not that one, just no.
Low on the spectrum. Low on the spectrum. We'll say that.
Yeah. Yeah. Dude, and, like, I've realized – this guy was telling me today that – there's no such thing as ADD. It's actually just like kids are bored.
It's fucking kids being kids, dude.
They're just bored.
Well,
and they
dude,
need
and
the playful
stimulation,
aspect.
Like,
yeah, they need the stimulation.
That energy.
Yeah.
You're sitting at home, jacking off.
Yeah, so when it was fun doing jiu-jitsu, and then my dad, like, dude, he's a smart dude. He kind of guided me without forcing me.
That's true.
And I think that's what this nation needs, dude. You know
your
what
dad
I mean?
For president.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And just guiding, you know, cultivating, but not forcing, helping the flow. I like to call it flow-centrated. It's like a concentrated flow.
Well, dude, yeah, you see that a lot when a parent wants something for their kid and they force it on them so hard. Then by the time the kid's in middle school, high school, the kid's like, fuck that. I was forced to do this my whole life. I don't want to do this
shit. They just
want
to be stoner, skater kid.
Yeah. But your dad obviously did it right because your brothers are in jiu-jitsu too, right?
Yeah. But the passion that has been built was always my decision, and that's that comes back to just free will, you know, giving them the circumstances to get better, but letting them control their own free will. That's the most important thing, and like then they're gonna just be they're passionate about it. It's like this is what I want to do, Dad. You know, I wrote that, dude. It's crazy because when I was six, I wrote down Jiu-Jitsu World Champion, Abu Dhabi Champion, and UFC Champion. Those are my goals.
When you were six.
When I was six.
That's crazy.
And. Dude, just this whole Abu Dhabi experience, man. It was like, okay, like another part. It's like, okay, maybe it wasn't exactly Abu Dhabi jiu-jitsu, but right. I was like, it's a part. Mm-hmm. It's on the same exact thing, and it's like everything happened. And I'm like, I'm literally in Abu Dhabi. in the UFC. Fighting in the UFC. And it's pretty crazy, man.
Because you have three other brothers and one sister, right?
Yep.
So your parents had five kids.
She's not single, bro.
You think that stopped?
I know she's not, but we've been talking.
Your boyfriend's pretty big, man. I'll catch his neck, dude. No, he does bench, dude.
Or he might go over
it. Bro, his max bench is like... like 300, dude.
But damn, yeah, five kids and all your brothers are in grappling sports. That's pretty fucking sweet.
Yeah.
Especially in California, it's such an expensive place. Like a jiu-jitsu membership out there is, what, $250 a month at least?
Because it's the hub as well. And I think things are just more expensive out there, especially with like, it's high tech, dude. They all got all the gi companies out there. You can go up the street. You got Atos and you go San Diego and you go up the street and you got Mendez Bros, Kings MMA. There's so many gyms out there. For just jiu-jitsu alone also, you know, and
yeah.
Awesome.
But it's like everybody knows everybody. It's a small world, man. I think the community of jiu-jitsu too, that's why like guys like Tonquinhos are so popular in the jiu-jitsu community because they stick together. Jiu-jitsu people stick together. Boxing people, they stick together. Oh. It's like the tribal thing. The wrestlers, they stick together and they support their people.
Yeah.
MMA is kind of free for all, you know?
Yeah.
So it's cool to see that.
Yeah, it is, and it's cool just being Phoenix, and no matter what, we can find someone who's better than us in something and yeah. Keep fucking getting better in the shit.
Yeah, what are we at for time, Phoenix boys? Phoenix is the hub, bro.
That's about perfect. Hour. Perfect. Episode 104. Thanks for our brother Kyler for coming on, who just started his own YouTube page.
Awesome.
You're going to start coming out with pods, I think, what, once, twice a month, and then slowly start building it from there?
Yeah, I'm going to try to do twice a month. That would be cool. So
that would be good.
Just some type of content, because I don't know what else to do with myself.
Dude, you got so much fucking skills, and you got so much you can teach the younger kids, the 18 to 20-something, like mentality-wise, eating healthy-wise, discipline-wise, all that shit. It's going to help a lot.
Yeah. Get Rob a lot on the of pod, people. Too. Ascended Arts.
Peace. Ooh. Crystal Rob.
All right, boys. Thanks to our sponsors, Jocko Fuel. Code Sugar Show for 15% off. It's what we're sipping.
You 3 years.
It's pretty good, dude.
It's good. Quality shit.
Clean.
Okay. Episode 104. See you next week.
This week, weekend, we got Marlon Moraes versus Corey Sandhagen. That's a good fucking fight. I'm going to pick Corey Sandhagen. Young, up-and-comer, moves a lot. It's going to be a sweet kickboxing match. On mybookie.ag, they got, it's almost dead even. So that's going to be a good, Corey Sandhagen, I feel like he's going to win that fight. On mybookie.ag, the co-main event, we got Makwan Amirkhani versus Edson Barboza. Edson Barboza's Makwan's the underdog on mybookie. That's a good bet. That Makwan guy can crack hard. He's always got the options for a right hand. Edson's super sharp, but that Makwan's a tough motherfucker and has some power in his hands. Marcus Perez versus Dricus. Marcin Tybura versus Ben Rothwell, the heavyweight sluggers. That Marcin Tybura, he can knock people out too, and Ben Rothwell's and he's the underdog, so that's a good bet there too. A bunch of good fights, like I said. Mybookie.ag, if you feel you can pick the fights, NFL, if you feel you can pick the game winners, bet on your team, whatever you deposit, they'll double it. Mybookie.ag, code TimboSugarShow.